Temperature, by definition, is a measure of how something is cold or hot, but due to the lack of scientific consistency in the terms cold or hot, we use temperature with different scales to describe the thermodynamic state of any object. In particular, temperature is a measurement of the average kinetic energy of the particles at the molecular and atomic levels of an object. That is the type of energy corresponding to the motion of these particles. The faster these particles move, the more kinetic energy they have. Furthermore, these particles are consistently colliding with each other, resulting in many variations in the kinetic energy associated with each particle. Therefore, we take the average kinetic energy of the total number of particles to avoid such variations. On being familiar with the concept of temperature, you may wonder what makes objects hot and what makes them cold. In other words, the limit between the cold and the hot, and based on what foundation we constructed such a limit. In order to demonstrate that limit, scientists came up with two terms. The absolute hot, which is the upper limit of the highest temperature that is possible in the entire universe, and the absolute zero, which is the lowest temperature ever at which the particles at the atomic level stop moving and lose their vibrational motion, hence their kinetic energy. Driven by the embrace the extremes principle, in this video, we're introducing the most extreme temperatures in the universe, both observed and man-made. Here's the list from the hottest to coldest temperatures. Number 10. The highest possible theoretical temperature ever is the Planck temperature, which is 10 to the power of 32 Kelvin. It was the temperature of the universe, 10 to the power of minus 43 seconds after the moment of the Big Bang. The Big Bang model states that our universe, at its beginning, 13.7 billion years ago, was in an extremely hot and dense state, which motivated the development of the standard model of strong and electroweak interactions. Not to mention the extending and expanding, the original Big Bang model, where the fundamental particles including the quarks and leptons as point-like particles. Consequently, the early universe can be pictured as a dilute gas of weakly interacting quarks, leptons, and gauge bosons. Number 9. The hottest man-made temperatures ever have been achieved by the physicist at CERN's Large Hadron Collider near Geneva, Switzerland. They recorded 5.5 trillion Kelvin by colliding lead ions to momentarily create a quark gluon plasma, which is pretty much like a subatomic plasma that is thought to have existed just moments after the Big Bang. The experiment was performed by the Alice Collider in 2012. By these results, the physicists were able to create a quark gluon plasma that is 38% hotter than the Guinness record holder, the 4 trillion Kelvin plasma achieved in 2010 by a similar experiment at the RHIC Brookhaven, New York. The ability to achieve such high temperatures enables the physicists to map the early stages of our universe through tracing the phase transitions of the quark gluon plasma. Number 8. The core temperature of a dying massive star comes in the third place, with approximately 10 to 100 billion Kelvin. As you probably already know, the star is a sphere of gas held together by its own gravitational pull. Its life is considered as a constant struggle against this gravitational pull, since gravity is constantly trying to cause the star to collapse. However, it's not the only force acting on the star during its lifetime. The star's core is extremely hot and radiates heat from the hydrogen fusion into helium, which results in the radiation pressure that pushes outwards, counteracting the force of gravity and putting the star in a state of hydrostatic equilibrium. Most of the star's lifetime is called the main sequence stage, at which there is an equilibrium between the gravitational pull acting inward and the radiation pressure acting downward. During the main sequence, the heat and radiation come from the nuclear reactions at the core, but eventually the core runs out of its hydrogen fuel and transitions into other stages, provided that the star is massive enough to go through some other nuclear reactions. At first, the outer layers will swell out into a red supergiant. Next, the core will shrink as it becomes more dense and hot. Then the helium fusion into carbon will begin, and it will shrink again once it runs out of its helium fuel. The massiveness of the core will allow for the carbon fusion into neon. Eventually, it will undergo several nuclear reactions until the core is filled up with iron atoms. The previous reactions were exothermic, that resulted in heat and radiation. However, the iron fusion reaction is endothermic, that requires energy input in order to occur, which means that a core filled up with iron atoms will lose its fight against gravity, since there will be no longer a radiation pressure induced by the core reactions pushing outward. The gravitational pull will crush the iron atoms together, raising the core's temperature to approximately 100 billion Kelvin, and there will be a repulsive force between the nuclei, overcoming the gravitational pull. Eventually, there will be a great explosion known as the supernova. About 75% of the star's mass is ejected into space during the supernova, and the fate of the leftover is determined by the star's original mass, whether a neutron star or a black hole. Number 7. The highest temperature in our solar system is the internal temperature of the Sun, which is approximately 15.7 million Kelvin. It's important for you to know this due to the significance of the Sun's role in the evolution of life on our planet. Before moving to the extreme cold temperatures, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve our content and make these videos better for you. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Number 6. The coldest temperature in the solar system, 38 Kelvin, was measured in 1989 by Voyager 2 on the surface of Triton, which is one of Neptune's moons, and it's barely chilly by comparison to the coldest temperatures. Additionally, the coldest temperature ever recorded on Earth is approximately 184 Kelvin. It was recorded at the Soviet Vostok station in Antarctica on July 21, 1983 by ground measurements. Number 5. The temperature of the cosmic microwave background is about 2.74 Kelvin, which is considered one of the coldest temperatures on the cosmological scale. The formation of the CMB radiation was an extremely complex process. 100,000 years after the Big Bang, the recombination era began. In that era, the universe temperature was cool enough for the free nuclei and electrons to combine and form atoms. Before the era of recombination, the universe was opaque to any form of electromagnetic radiation, even light, due to the large number of free electrons. Although the universe was a coupled state of photons and baryons, and there were approximately 10 to the power 6 photons for every electron, no photon was safe from being scattered by the free electrons. The baryon photon plasma enjoyed three profound differences between the behavior of matter at this state compared to the gentle gas nebula of the modern universe. First, the baryon photon plasma was opaque since there exists no lines of sight to anything during that time. Second, light was able to exert an enormous amount of pressure on this plasma, leading to the production of the colossal sound waves. And third, those sound waves traveled very fast, at approximately half the speed of light. The baryons underwent a phase transition from a baryon photon plasma to a gas. This phase transition is called recombination. While free electrons are able to interact with any frequency of light, the electrons bound into atoms are restricted to only those specific frequencies corresponding to the energy level transitions of that atom. Consequently, light and matter decoupled, and the universe went from opaque to transparent over several thousand years. As the wave of plasma and photons decoupled, light began to stream freely through the universe as the cosmic background radiation. However, the plasma, which is now hydrogen and helium gas, stalled and the speed of sound dropped from half the speed of light to only hundreds of meters per second. The wave of the plasma turned gas essentially froze in its current state. The radius of that shell became fixed to the rate of the universe's expansion itself. Moreover, the exact distance that sound could travel over the age of the universe at that time is known as the sound horizon. At the time of the recombination era, the sound horizon was around 500,000 light years. Number 4. The bulk aluminum metal turns superconductive at approximately 1.2 Kelvin. Superconductivity, by definition, is the ability to transmit electricity without any resistance, which means that no energy loss during the transmission process. The resistance is the main reason that electrical gadgets like laptops or even smartphones heat up when leaving them on for a long time. The electricity meets resistance as it courses the machine circuits, resulting in heat, which is a form of energy loss. The good news is that it might not be the case in the future, as a team led by Vitaly Creason, professor of physics at the University of Southern California, USC, found that aluminum superatoms form pairs of electrons at temperatures around 100 Kelvin. In order to fully understand this, you may need to know that superatoms are homogeneous clusters of atoms, and the copper pairs are two electrons that attract one another in some materials under certain conditions, such as extreme low temperatures, and they were first predicted by Leon Cooper in 1956. The superconductivity is measured by the ability of these materials to form Cooper pairs, and according to Professor Creason, this may be the discovery of a new family of superconductors and raises the possibility that other types of superatoms will be capable of superconductivity at even warmer temperatures. It might be a matter of time before discovering superconductors at the room temperature. Can you imagine what will be the implications of this discovery? If superconductors can be harnessed, they will totally transform the world. For instance, they will increase the power of computers while reducing the cost of electricity and the emission of greenhouse gases. They will provide a fuel-free transportation system and an alternative way of screening the human body without the use of dangerous x-rays. Number 3. The coldest known natural temperature in the universe is 1 Kelvin, the temperature of the Boomerang Nebula, which is about 5,000 light-years from Earth in the direction of the southern constellation Centaurus. It was first identified by Australian astronomers in 1979. Its name is derived from symmetry of its structure as seen from ground-based telescopes, as it looks like a boomerang, or more possibly, a bow tie. There's a dying star that's three times heavier than our own sun at its core. Furthermore, for the last 1,500 years, the nebula has been spraying out gas at a speed of more than 300,000 miles per hour. That gas squeezed out of the nebula is approximately 1 Kelvin, which is the lowest natural temperature so far recorded. Number 2. The lowest, coldest man-made temperature ever recorded has been achieved by the researchers of the YKI group of the Low Temperature Laboratory in Otaniemi, Espoo, Finland. The record low temperature was reached in a piece of rhodium metal, which was cooled to 100 pK or picokelvin. However, the main objective of these experiments was not the sole purpose of achieving the record low temperature, but to study the magnetism of the nuclei of the rhodium atoms. Each of the billions of nuclei in rhodium has a magnetic moment like a small compass needle. And by lowering the temperature, researchers expected the moments to freeze based on similar ultra-cold experiments that were performed with other elements such as copper and silver. Unexpectedly, the rhodium atoms did not freeze even at this record low temperature. Number 1. The coldest possible theoretical temperature ever is the absolute zero, or at 0 Kelvin. It's the lowest possible temperature where nothing could be colder and no heat remains in a substance. It's the point at which all the fundamental particles have zero vibrational motion, hence zero kinetic energy. Thanks for watching, everyone. Do you think it's possible to reach superconductivity at high temperatures? Can you think of other applications of superconductors in our daily life? Can you guess the fate of the dying star at the center of the Boomerang Nebula? Did you learn anything new in this video? Please let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.